Hey folks, Officer 5 here, continuing Horizon Zero Dawn. We are wrapped up most of the collectibles. I just have one more cup to get here. And then I do have to do the Grazer statues, but I read most of them are over here in this region. So we'll worry about those as we make our way back eventually. But we're going to go ahead and continue main story. We've made a long journey. It took about 2 days gaming, which I think was about 8 hours, just to get here, while getting all the collectibles, and we finished up some other story-based missions, including the hunting grounds, so that was good. So let's go ahead and continue. I do know that there's a power cell here, too, for the ultimate armor, but from what I've read, the ultimate armor seems a little overpowered, so I'm probably not going to get it until after completing main story, just to make my life more enjoyable. But let's do this.
Eclipse, just like you said.
Got something.
Snow. It's not getting any warmer out here.
Forged Earth Delvers made off with any riches long ago, but not the ancients buried in the ground.
I'm going in! No! Oh.
Haven't you got anything better to do?
Oh, I wonder if that's what handling does. How good's my handling on this? Handling's how fast I aim. Okay. That makes a lot more sense.
Looks like I'm clear.
Nothing here.
They're scanning for me.
Gotta get the demons raised to the ground fields again.
No danger. Almost makes me miss the points.
These dig sites, they're massive.
She's here!
Giving up.
I might need to switch to the. Oh, yeah. I have enough skill points. Oh, fuck. I think that helps me right now. No, that does 186. How much does my trip caster do? It's rope caster. Where's trip caster? Oh, no, the explosives do more. Alright. Ice arrows and whatnot are gonna work as well here.
We found the destroyer against the frostbitten temple. That's not easy.
Now they're hunting me.
got you located.
Explosion.
Deathbringer, it's the final robot I haven't killed.
Rotate turret! And fire!
All weapons operating. Time to get it moving, and be quick about it. No daydreaming.
All machines cataloged.
To be one of the Deathbringers Olin talked about. Fitting name. I'll never get into that tower. Unless I destroy that thing first. Upper hand. What is this?
The entity lives. Unacceptable. Unacceptable. Unacceptable.
Stranger, did you see that? No answer, huh? Figures. Things just keep getting stranger. I need to find a way inside the tower. Looks tight, but I can squeeze through.
For identity scan.
One of these again.
Genetic profile confirmed. Entry authorized. Greetings, Dr. Sobek. Please step inside.
Seems too high to be daughter.
Dr. Sobek, you are 355,510 days overdue for your meeting with Mr. Farrell. Please proceed to the 35th room.
Wait. 350,000? That's hundreds of years ago. What's going on?
Use polyphasic entangled waveforms, quantum encryption, black quartz stuff, way beyond military grade. That's what you demanded. So that's what we delivered.
You don't code something you can't crack. All we need is a backdoor. Upload the latest service pack update and the problem goes away.
You specifically forbade us from leaving anything resembling a backdoor in code. Every protocol to black quartz standard. Your words. Look. If you need me to fudge some projections, it's nothing we haven't done before.
I don't need fudged projections. I need a way to reassert control over the Heart's Timor Swarm.
I don't know what to tell you, Ted. You're asking the impossible.
So, codes. They needed codes of some kind to control the machines. But they got out of control.
Alright, so
bad.
I think I am right. I think it was a worm.
A Deathbringer. A statue of one, anyway. A machine built to kill. And they honored it?
Welcome to Feral Automated Solutions, where all the problems of tomorrow are being solved today. With over 25,000 human employees based in nations and corporate holdings across the globe, Feral leads the world in every sector of self-sustaining, fully automated technology. Revolutionary consumer products close to home, like the Feral Focus, to the dynamic chariot line of peacekeeping robots halting bloodshed in conflict zones across the globe, Feral remains committed to making the future smarter, brighter, safer, and always surprising. Feral Automated Solutions. For every problem of life, a smart solution.
So they made the Focus. 25,000 people? That's bigger than a tribe. So, they made machines and devices I guess those things were common in their world.
Welcome to Feral Automated Solutions.
What was this place? What were they doing here?
It was a corporation.
2020?
Go on.
I've uploaded some data files to your Focus. They'll help you understand.
Wait, did he upload other things, or was it just that? Of course, military and defense contracts. That explains all the robots. Green and climate cleanup. Must have been those things that caused the world to go haywire. That's the journal from earlier.
Now, I know this must seem like a bizarre change in direction. I mean, we're Feral Automated Solutions, right? Number one robotics firm in the world. Why would we clear our production slate to fabricate human-operated vehicles and weapon systems, the relics of the past? All I can say at this juncture is... trust me, we will be exploiting a massive, growth opportunity by retooling and reallocating capacity according to my plan. So I will need revised projections of mass fabrication velocity across every pipeline within 36 hours.
So they were making machines, and they stopped to make other kinds of weapons? Why? Even old death. Nothing natural. Another cave-in. But I could get through.
Set up the coffee fight just to cause more fighting. Oh my gosh, that's called war profiteering. I thought they said there were 35 floors.
Climb here.
Thank you. grief, what kind of protesting happened?
People were angry at Faro, the corporation. They blamed this place for something. Something bad. Looks like the way up.
Yeah.
What's left of it.
So now we're actually getting some semblance of the story.
The ACA-3 Scarab combines conventional and information warfare capabilities in one package. Designed for high-speed, all-terrain reconnaissance, it boasts the world's highest survivability rating of any Scout-class autonomous agent. Maybe it's the Scarab's emergency biomass conversion systems that ensure it always makes it back to base, even if fuel supply lines have been interdicted. Or maybe it's the Scarab's ability to slave enemy robots to its own network. Now that's force multiplication. Add a prehensile manipulator arm that can handle a host of functions. From 360-degree less lethal riot management to surgical repairs of allied chariot line models. And you've got the workhorse of any cutting-edge peacekeeping fleet.
The Corruptor. Slave enemy robots to its own network. Sounds like it's talking about how it corrupts machines.
Same thing.
The FSP-5 Kopesh provides a one-size-fits-all solution to main battle force capability. Metamaterial construction delivers unmatched recoil dampening, allowing you to field any weapon package that conforms to your budget needs and conflict resolution profile. Patented biomass conversion systems allow extended emergency operations with minimal environmental impact. Multilinear target processing provides simultaneous real-time threat analysis and legal review for autonomous domestic operations, or could... The FSP-5 Kopesh provides a one-size-fits-all solution to main battle force capability. Metamaterial construction delivers unmatched recoil dampening, allowing you to field any weapon package that conforms to your budget needs and conflict resolution profile. Patented biomass conversion systems allow extended emergency operations with minimal environmental impact. Multilinear target processing provides simultaneous real-time threat analysis and legal review for autonomous domestic operations. Or control can be slaved to the swarm's neural network for weapons-free force application. Either way, when it's time to call out the big guns, it's time to call Kopesh.
The Deathbringer. So this was the heavy hitter. Main battle force indeed.
And what are you?
The BOR-7 Horus. Imagine your complete engagement ecosystem comprehensively managed by a high-speed learning machine network. Whether your need is to replace battlefield losses or intensify force projection, the Horus's onboard manufacturing capabilities mean you'll never get stuck waiting for the next arms delivery. Simply redefine your force parameters, and the Horus will fabricate additional units to fill the ranks for an affordable per-unit licensing fee. Meanwhile, the biomass conversion systems of other Chariot line models allow them to keep the Horus fueled, repaired, and ready, extending its operational tolerances beyond that of any competing Titan-class platform. That's the Horus advantage. Always regulating, always ready. The future of automated warfare made real today.
The Metal Devil. So these were farm machines too. Manufacturing capabilities. They can make more of themselves. Then how would you ever stop them?
EMP? Do they even have one of those in this world?
Of the way. Not making this easy, Dr. Sobek. If plants can find a way to hang on up here, guess I can too.
Engaged in unauthorized offensive operations against robots and human personnel of the Hearts Timor Energy Combine. Now, I wish that I could relate that the crisis has been exaggerated, but it's not. The peacekeepers have not responded to stand down codes, and by all signs, they appear to be replicating at a precipitous rate. Now, what I can promise and absolutely assure you is that I am already devoting every possible resource towards reaching a speedy conclusion to this issue. So when you hear the bad talk about us against this company in the days, maybe weeks to come, just bear in mind that we will get past this. And a day's coming when none of this will matter.
Peacekeepers. That's what they call their machines. They were built for war, not peace.
Why was there a robot eating mangoes?
Huh.
sure I'm not missing any info hubs.
Use these.
Dolphins.
The way up. All it takes is a few good handholds. All right. Made it. Wonder what we'll find.
Okay, I know they said it's at the very top for the one collectible. I'm betting it's up here.
Another power cell. This should help me get to that ancient armor.
I guess she couldn't fling her rope that high, even if it is that long to bring down.
Data has been erased from this device. Do you wish to deploy item privileges to recover purged data?
Oh yes, I believe I do.
The file has been recovered.
Elizabeth, good to, it's been years.
Where's your legal team, Ted?
No need. I dropped all 18 lawsuits the moment you landed. I assume your data confirms this.
All right, this promises to be interesting.
Perhaps we could have lunch brought in. You know, get reacquainted.
I know you, Ted. You've screwed something up, something big, or you wouldn't have eaten the crow necessary to get me here. So spit it out.
There's a glitch in the chariot line.
You're killing robots?
Peacekeepers, yes. Those.
So shut them down.
Obviously, Liz, we would, if we could. They're not responding.
Are you telling me a swarm has gone rogue, Ted?
It's worse than that.
Show me the data then. And we'll take that lunch. Alone.
Ted Faro brought Elizabeth Sobeck here. But they hated each other.
Another Faro has been recovered.
Goody. This isn't a glitch. It's a catastrophe.
Fully aware. It's bad.
Bad?
Jesus, Liz.
It's not bad, Ted. It's apocalyptic. You built a line of killer robots.
Peacekeepers.
That consume biomass as fuel.
In emergencies.
And you made them capable of self-replication.
Limited self-manufacture controlled.
Not anymore. The glitch severed chain of command. The only nation this swarm answers to now is itself.
You think I did?
Everything else is just food. And at the rate it's replicating, Ted, it will strip the Earth bare in 15 months. We're not talking fall of civilization. We're talking extinction.
I get it, Liz. So how will I stop it while it's contained?
It's not contained. It can't be.
You know what I mean.
Right. Before the truth gets out, you mean.
Liz, I will do anything you say. Keep working it, and whatever you recommend, I'll do.
I'm gonna hold you to that, Ted.
The Faro robots threatened all life on Earth. But somehow she defeated them. The world of the old ones fell, but life went on, or we wouldn't be here.
A final Faro has been recovered.
Project Zero Dawn. Jesus, Liz. There has to be another way.
If there were a nicer way to fix your mess, I would have proposed it.
But this? This? When I asked you to find a cure, I didn't expect it to be worse than the disease.
It's not, Ted. It may be grim, but it's our only chance. Now sign the proposal.
Sign it? I can't sign that.
Yes, you can.
That? Liz, I cannot in good conscience sign that.
You've got a choice, Ted.
I know.
I'm speaking to you from a VTOL en route to U.S. Robot Command. In 15 minutes, I meet with General Harris and the rest of the Joint Chiefs.
What? Are you crazy?
Now your choice is what I tell them. Sign, and I'll tell them the wealthiest corporation on Earth has guaranteed the funds necessary to build Zero Dawn. Exactly as I've designed it. Or don't sign, and I will make sure they and everyone else on this planet knows the real cause of the glitch.
Jesus, Liz. You don't have to threaten me. I'll sign.
Look on the bright side, Ted. From here on out, you get to do what you've always been good at. Footing the bill while others get their hands dirty.
God, forgive me.
Her solution so terrible. What does she do to stop the robots?
Executive access detected. Express lift opened.
How convenient.
This doesn't add up. Sobeck couldn't have been my mother. She lived ages ago. All this searching, and I'm still no closer.
That's your reaction to everything you've just learned? To whine like a spoiled child?
You should really try talking that way to me face to face.
As you wish.
Lance Reddick.
Do you really have no idea how monumental are the discoveries you just made, Aloy? I expected more of you.
So, you have a face. Got a name to go with it?
Of all the questions you could ask right now, that's the one you choose. I've spent decades searching the ruins of the old ones, trying to solve the mystery of what happened to them. For years, I've suspected that Faro robots destroyed their civilization, but I could never confirm it. And in minutes, you uncover more ancient knowledge than I have in a lifetime, and what you want to know is my name. Silence. That's my name. Now, why don't you try asking another question? Something less trivial.
If you're so smart, why do you know so little after a lifetime scratching around in the dirt? It's not my fault you're bad at what you do. I came to these ruins looking for Elizabeth Sobeck, not because of the things she did centuries ago, but because people are trying to kill me right now, today. I've got bigger problems to deal with than your crap.
Congratulations. You just graduated from whining to throwing a temper tantrum. I'm sure Elizabeth would be proud. You need to get a grip on yourself and start thinking straight. Only then will you see just how big your problems really are.
What exactly are you talking about?
You've chased a personal riddle into a crowd of larger mysteries. The common thread is your connection to Elizabeth Sobeck.
But what is that connection? She couldn't have been my mother if she lived centuries ago.
We don't know the connection yet. The only way to find out is to keep going, to keep making discoveries. Thanks to you, we've only just now learned that Pharaoh robots once threatened to end life on Earth.
But it didn't happen. The Old One civilization was destroyed, but life was saved.
Obviously. So, what did Elizabeth do? How did she stop the robots before all was lost?
What was Project Zero Dawn?
Exactly the question. Now, are you ready to go get the answer?
Of course I am.
Then why are you still standing here?
Not so fast, Silence. You've got some explaining to do.
I've told you quite enough. If you still got questions, be quick about it and stop wasting my time.
You said you've known for some time that Pharaoh war machines destroyed the civilization of the Old Ones.
The evidence pointed that way. But until now, I never knew the full scope of their danger. That they could process organic matter into fuel, or that the Horus class could manufacture more robots. Like a cauldron on legs.
But the robots we've seen so far, the Corruptors and Deathbringers, they don't do those things.
Not yet, anyway. So far, we haven't encountered any that are undamaged. At full power, who knows what they're capable of. Now, if that's enough talking, be on your way.
Oh, no. I'm just getting started. You've been getting a free ride on my Focus, risking nothing while I risk everything. All I have to do is take this thing off my head. And you'll be blind, deaf, and dumb. So quit complaining, and answer my questions.
Very well. Proceed.
Who are you, Silence? And what are your intentions?
You really need to make this personal. I'm a lone wanderer who left his tribe behind a long time ago. An explorer of forbidden places, a searcher of lost knowledge. Exactly as I said.
Why do you know so much about the Eclipse?
I happen to know a lot about a lot of things. If what you're really asking is whether I work for the Eclipse or anyone else, I don't. I am nothing if not independent.
So far as I can tell, the Eclipse are just following orders. It's Hades who wants me dead. Who is he?
I don't know. The Eclipse describe him as a buried shadow, some kind of devil.
That thing that spoke to me outside, that made that Focus explode. That was Hades. It didn't seem like a person or a machine. More like a phantom, with a terrible voice.
All that's certain is that he wants you dead.
Because of my connection to Elizabeth. Has to be.
Hades is using the Eclipse to resurrect Pharaoh robots.
But if Elizabeth found a way to stop them centuries ago, if she made special weapons, maybe Hades is worried I'll do the same thing.
In some of the ancient data I've recovered, there are hints of so-called super weapons being developed. Maybe to stop the robots, the civilization of the Old Ones had to destroy itself.
You've been using my focus to spy on me. How's that possible?
Every focus emits a signal, a voice that only other focuses can hear. I know how to string those voices together, how to make them talk to each other, to communicate, even over vast distances.
How do you learn to do that?
Years of study and experimentation. In principle, it's not so different from how you override machines. I override focuses.
And you can spy through other eclipses' focuses, too.
Usually. All I'll say is that overriding the connections is complicated.
Is there any chance that Elizabeth Sobeck could still be alive somehow?
It's highly unlikely, but not impossible. Some of the ancient data I've recovered includes mentions of life extension techniques. Pharmaceuticals, mostly. An ancient word for medicine. But some were still trying to perfect ways of freezing and unfreezing people.
Freezing and unfreezing people?
Cryogenics, they called it. But there were problems with it. Given Elizabeth's technological acumen, I can't definitively rule out that she found a way to make herself immortal. But this is speculation. Wasting time.
Elizabeth told Ted Farrow she was headed for a place called U.S. Robot Command to tell people about Zero Dawn.
The place still exists as a ruin. The Asuram call it the Grave Horde.
Grave Horde? Cheery name.
You'll find it in the Eastern Mountains, buried under the tangled coils of a metal devil, or a BOR-7 Horus, rather, as we're learning to call them. I'll contact you when you get there.
I can't wait. Someday we'll meet in person, and your manners had better be improved.
What is it with Lance Reddick and always being the mysterious guy?
Getting down will be a lot faster than getting up here, at least. U.S. Robot Command next. To learn the secrets of Zero Dawn.
Should be the only mission I have left. Since I know I need all the things, I'm not going to bother with the, armory yet. Like I said, I also heard that the armor is going to be a joke. Oh look! I already have enough for all abilities. And there goes that trophy. All skills learned. Alright, I can call them out from whenever now. Or wherever. Oh, I think I saw... No, no, that was just an iron box. They gave me a fast travel pack. But the load times takes too long, so I'm gonna just travel. Now, I'm curious... Where are you? There you are. Like, am I gonna get a horse, or am I gonna get a ram?
Here comes the snow.
I'm still leaning towards she's a clone. As if the robots have the ability to genetically, or not genetically, if the robots have a way to reconstruct themselves, I'm wondering if they have the same technology for humans. Oh look, it's a ram. I'll take it. Let's go. Warp to two teeth. definitely going to be quicker than traveling. Meridian, as much as I enjoy getting all the collectibles, it didn't seem like there was any incentive for me to turn in the collectibles, since they usually just gave me terrible modifications. So I'm not going to really worry about that unless I am actually forced to go to Meridian. Oh look! I'm with my mount, too! Yelling at me to get off the mount.
I'll find a use for you.
I think I got the one. They said there's only one here. I thought it was up here. When I got it. This is one of the bandit camps that you had to take over. Yep, sure enough, it's right there. Alright. The first one.
When was the last time an outcast was made a secret?
Oh, there it is. Okay. Yeah, we'll swing by there on our way up. So we'll hit that, and then hit that. Call him to join me. startled me. I'm getting sniped. Side quest here. Apparently I missed a side quest, that's not good.
Little Spark, name's Jira. I run this fine watering hole.
I like what you've done with the place. Something troubling you, Jira?
When the Carja Fort opened, I got word that my husband had come looking for me. But only the word made it to the fort. He didn't.
You have a husband?
Kendrick. Beat him in an arm wrestling match. I left him behind when I left the claim. Some metal sellers passed him at the bridge near the glare break. Seeing as you drift on the wind, little Spark.
If I'm out that way, I'll look for him, but do you want him to find you, Jira?
Ever have those mornings when you wake up without all the answers? Still, I'll be heading up to the fort to resupply. Luck on your travels.
The one about the sun priest falling in love with a merchant's daughter.
Good to take a load off that.
I claim we still got it.
Thank you.
took them long enough.
Because I didn't use a save point, it put me okay. I guess we're doing this the easy way. You'd think if I ran by a fire, they would just give me the checkpoint. But okay.
Here's the bridge Jira mentioned. No telling how many people pass this way. But this was a man with a cart, so... the road. End of the tracks. Well, that doesn't make any sense. Someone's possessions. Gendert's? There's goods scattered everywhere. And a little blood, too. Either he fell, or... enough blood to worry me. Blood. Must have had time to bind his wound. This chest looks like it's a Vosseron making. At least he's easy to follow. I just hope he's okay.
Glad to see you, stranger.
Are you a defender? I'm a friend of Juris.
Huh? I'm a husband of Juris.
She heard you'd gone missing. I tracked you. What happened?
I was coming to join her. A sandstorm blew in. I sought shelter. It didn't work out. Here I am getting ready to target priests. My goods scattered in a herd of tramplers. There's only so much you can do to make me look less of an idiot. But could you get back my scrapper sap?
That would be the stuff down there with the herd of tramplers?
I'm not proud. I'm just a boy. Maybe 5 bottles of that is worth more than I am to Jura.
It's heavy. World's coming.
Huntress. Thank you. Oseram's finest, this stuff. Keeps you warm in a snowstorm. Strips the grit out of a gear wheel.
Kendert, why did you set out so unprepared?
Hammer to steel of the matter is. I did it for love. When Jira said she wanted to leave the claim, I consulted with the Ildermen. I won't repeat what they said. You won't like it.
You've got me curious.
No. I've already dug myself a hole deep enough to swallow a thunderjaw. It was my mistake not going with her. I've had time enough to see that. Maybe it's not too late.
You'll find her stocking up at Day Tower. Good luck.
It's our Sun King's savior.
Little Spark. Any sign of that man?
I found him, Jira. I think you two will have a lot to talk about.
I like a good story. A good drink. It's why I'm good at what I do.
He's bringing you both. Kendert wants to be with you. He regrets that he took the word of the Ildermen.
Women know their place in the claim, was their word. It's the Karja's son that bakes their brains and gives them such thoughts.
That's
the tribe. You can't bear a grudge. It'd make you go mad. My silly man.
Wow.
Little Spark. How can I thank you? There'll always be a drink for you at Hunter's Gathering.
That crazy awesome tried to kill us.
Easy, easy.
Thank you.
not his fault. For dreamers. I feel that time come too soon.
Oh, Mother, remember those who have fallen to corruption and slaughter. Show mercy on them.
It's spreading. The corrupted machines.
Not now.
They're everywhere.
You had to climb up the ladder right next to them. Yep, here they are.
Ready or not?
So that's those two. Alright, so Devil Thirst Camp's down that way, so I'm not gonna bother with them yet. We're gonna go ahead and continue our way up north to the Grave Horde. I just don't want to instantly warp there because last time he offered me supplies, so he might offer more or something else might happen as I'm making my way there.
It looks like that machine carries fluid in those sacks.
Oh boy.
Not sure.
Thank you. faster.
I'm ready. Gotta be.
this is the space I thought was the last level or something.
They're inside, too.
Oh, no, this is the place that had the ice was up, so I couldn't get in here.
Say again, Lieutenant.
I got some. Titan is through the defenses. Still on approach. Alive one. And it's best.
We've got no mobility in here. It'll punch right through us.
We hold the hatch at all costs. Then push back out.
Battle. Frozen in ice. In time.
Titan.
Are you getting this, Silence? Silence?
Titan inbound, same play as Akron. Base defense locks it down. We engage, sever the lens, blast out the fountains.
Another game of life!
Operation Victory.
By the sun!
Yeah, whatever it was, doesn't seem to have turned out very well. Around the room. Must have been where the soldiers slept. Like the lodge in Mother's Heart, I guess.
Log. Third Battle of California Marine. The swarm came in from the Pacific. I don't know if it was the local Minutemen or the crazy 15th, but they'd set the garbage patch alight. Man, the sea was on fire. That stuff was... The first wave of bots came in covered in burning sludge. It bought us an hour or two of slaughtering them on the beaches before the swarm recalculated. We pulled them inland, back through the Kalmar sprawl. Dropped buildings on them, EMP'd the grid. Standard operating procedure. The last time I was in California, I was... 5, 6? The light was like that vintage social net filter that was everywhere in the 40s. Log. First battle of the Eastern Seaboard Wall. Had a long run onto it. This was before Kalmar, and projections were a lot worse for the East. For 3 weeks, we kept getting scrambled out to some coastal burg to train Minutemen. It was always raining on account of Europe already being torched. Block after block of prefab barracks. They were still printing barracks right up until the hour the main force hit. The Minutemen? We ran combat drills with them in the streets where they'd lived, trying to pretend they might live to die somewhere else if they paid attention. Nothing worse than the ones who actually bought into it. Hopeful, pestering us with questions about Zero Dawn, like, we know something they don't. I swear, the more we do this, the more like the bots we are. Except they learn from every fight. And us? not so sure.
What was this place?
Recalls, I've been instructed to remind you of Article 115 of base policy regarding unauthorized use of processor cycles. Specifically, 115C. Any holographic simulation not directly related to operational training or efficiency. Consider yourself reminded and enjoy your gaming.
I know it's been days, honey. I'm so sorry. Deployments are getting real long and tougher every time. The swarm's getting better at predicting us. Less of us now. And we have to put in 10 times the work for everyone gone. Like a family business on hard times, only this isn't my family. It's not with you. I still try to see you. The life we had. In the eyes of the people out there. I remember when they were glad to see us. When they still had hope. It all seems to be slipping away. I don't even recognize the places we're defending. The only thing I know I'm still fighting for is... you. With Zero Dawn to turn this around? Whatever the hell that is. Thanks for the mails, you. Time goes fast in active duty. 4 months with the record recalls. I don't know, 20 drops. In and out of the West Coast, fighting with these civilian enlistees, scrappy guys and gals. Their training is basically, here's a DEW. When you see a bot, hit it. But somehow it's all coming together. Between us and the 6th MRB, we took down a horse at Lithium Beach. Pulled out before its buddies arrived, but to see a big one go down. I hope you made the news, honey. Showed everyone we're gonna have a shot at turning this around. We just need to give Project Zero Dawn the time it needs, and everything will be the way it used to be.
The furnishings were metal. How'd they ever get comfortable? It was the metal world. Guess they were used to it. Just one bed. Maybe the war chief's room.
Kind of reminds me of part of Metal Gear Solid 4 where they were saying about how everything had gone. Box. In terms of soldiers.
Red light. Guess that means no power. These wires must run to the power source. Oh, that's informative. A holographic interface. It must be some kind of code. Maybe I should try scanning objects in this area. Three power lines, resources. That makes one.
Hey, y'all wanted to know how I remember the geotherm system reboot? Goes like this. Bird flies north in summer, east in spring, west in fall, and south in winter. Didn't expect to hear nature poetry from the lips of Mike the GT Tech now, did you? As usual, I defy expectations.
That's two. Here. More, I should be able to get to that ancient armor I found. It's them, all right. They're not looking for answers, just weapons.
It's a map.
A map of what?
Our world. The planet Earth, Aloy. It's not flat like you thought.
Why would I think that? During eclipses, the shadow cast on the moon is curved. So our world is a globe. And it looks like this, from a distance.
We'll discuss this another time. Back to the matter at hand.
The Faro robots were spreading across the world, eating everything up. Somehow, Elizabeth stopped them before it was too late. But how? The eclipse. Tampering with a metal devil. They don't think they can wake him, do they?
Watch out!
Deathbringer. So sneaky. Hell down! Yeah, I can't imagine fighting hundreds of those all at once.
Sobek, as projected, the Wichita salient has collapsed. Five Horus-class Titans have broken through. We predict contact in 34 hours.
Everything is in position, General. It took a few shortcuts to pull everything together, but Zero Dawn is functionally complete. Good to go.
That enduring victory served its purpose after all.
Yes, if we'd had even one day less.
I've sent you an encoded file, Doctor. Please do me the favor of archiving it.
Oh, I'll see what I can do. What is it?
A brief statement. An allocution of crimes, I guess you'd call it.
To what are you admitting guilt?
Over the past 16 months, Doctor, I have presided over the greatest wholesale slaughter of military personnel and civilians in the history of... history. Genghis Khan, Hitler, Stalin, Sorabella, add them all together. They don't even come close.
You didn't do the killing, General.
No, not directly. But I didn't wind up the highest ranked military commander in the United States by resisting the automation of the armed forces. Even before the swarm, Doctor, I was helping death along. So, instead of letting what I've done sink into the murk, forgotten. I've sent a file with all the details. Let posterity judge my actions with clear vision.
I'll do as you ask, General. But you should consider that were it not for your actions, our actions, there wouldn't be any posterity to judge us.
Right. I'm not just so
at ease, General. And goodbye.
Hell of a thing.
Oh.
Thank you, Dr. Sobek. You can take a seat.
What? You're going to thank her after what she just said?
Dr. Sobek has made the situation very clear, General, and given us an option. We should all be thanking her.
No, it's just... I mean, my God!
Maybe take this discussion offline.
There's not going to be any discussion. You saw the numbers. Now, Pharaoh, he'll foot the bill, but his money can't buy the time necessary to complete Zero Dawn. That can only be paid for in blood.
Oh, come on. If we upgrade our fleet, crack the code somehow...
Were you not listening? Robots can't do the fighting for you this time. When it comes to hacking, this rogue swarm is an apex predator. Anything automated you throw at it, they will hijack and take over.
But this... We'd be throwing civilians into a meat grinder.
Commanders, the enemy we're facing self-replicates faster than we can kill it. And it eats biomass as fuel. Zero Dawn is all we've got.
So we put a railgun in the hand of every civilian strong enough to carry one, show them where the trigger is, and point them to the front? How the hell do we sell that?
By giving them something to fight for. Zero Dawn. The top secret super weapons program that will save us. So long as humanity holds off the swarm long enough for Dr. Sobeck and her team to finish it. The file I'm sending contains the war plan for Operation Enduring Victory.
War plan? This is a war crime.
It may be ugly, but it's something. Consider the alternative. Dr. Sobeck, I've secured use of a decommissioned orbital launch base outside Bryce, Utah as the Zero Dawn staging area. Plenty of space there. When can you get started?
I've already mailed you a list of Alpha and Beta candidates. Most are foreign nationals or subjects of corporate holdings, so extracting them...
Leave that to me. You'll get your dream team. Count on it.
Then I'll be off.
Orbital launch base. What is that? What did these people do? What did Elizabeth do? Glad to be rid of that place. Now I just need to find the orbital launch base they talked about.
I've checked my data and located the base. That's the good news.
And the bad?
It's directly underneath the Citadel. The palace at Sinfall.
The capital of the Shadow Quadrant.
That's what that was.
Not exactly convenient.
The palace is crawling with Eclipse agents. Many in positions of authority, all of them wearing focuses. The moment they see you, Hades will too. He'll issue another kill order, and this time, the entire Shadow Quadrant military will be after you.
So, disable their focuses. You've done it before.
It's not that simple. Too many focuses in one place. Each of them communicating with each other and back to Hades, a whole network of them.
Network? What's that?
Imagine a vast, invisible web stretched across the land from end to end, connecting focuses together, allowing them to communicate over vast distances instantaneously.
All right. So, is there some way to cut the web down?
Crash the network. Audacious. Yes. There is a way. A weak point in the network.
By the way.
I'll send the location data to your focus. Head there, and I'll be in touch when you're close with more directions.
What was Zero Dawn? What sort of super weapon did Elizabeth make? She stopped the machines. Not before the world she knew. Her civilization ended. Let's hope it won't come to that again.
Dark
Valve. No, How am I gonna get down from here? Oh, this should be quite the ride. I'd do that again, if it weren't so much work to get back up there.
Amen to that. There's a merchant there, too. It's probably easier to do that one. Real quick, where's that stupid thing?